If you thought VHS was bad, how about recording video directly onto audio tape? Because there's nothing badder. In 1987, Fisher Price made a toy video camera that recorded video onto audio cassettes, the PixelVision PXL-2000. It produced ghostly black and white images that ended up scaring off all the kids it was intended for. As a toy, it flopped and sat in discount bins for the rest of the 1980s. Since then, this camera remains a historical engineering curiosity. The 8-bit guy did a good technical exploration of how well it worked. This camera records at 15 frames per second, black and white, and 120 by 90 pixels. To achieve this, the mechanism runs the tape at almost 9 times standard audio cassette speed. Despite its technical limitations, or rather because of them, this camera became popular with artists and filmmakers. Oddity Archive did a good cultural analysis in a YouTube video that's worth checking out. Links in the description below. I've always been really intrigued by this camera's ability to record video on audio tapes. Unfortunately, I don't have a PXL2000 camera. Instead, I'm going to try recording video using this Sony D6C Walkman as a kind of rudimentary VCR. The frequency response, or bandwidth available, on audio cassettes is about 16 kHz, depending on the tape quality. This 16 kHz is about 1/10 the bandwidth of the PXL2000, which used a much faster tape speed. To get this to work, I'm going to use the excellent resources of the Narrowband Television Association, whose members have already been figuring out low bandwidth television for many years. As the source, I've used some video from 1987, the year of the PXL2000, and recorded that onto these tapes. I'll be using this Fujitsu Lifebook as the video signal decoder and displaying the image on this screen in real time as the tape plays. In the next part of this video, we'll look at how this was recorded. But first, I want to play these back and see if we get a recognizable image. Let's have a look and see what we get. I'd be impressed if you recognized anything from these images. Also, you may have noticed some color creeping in there. Let's have a look at some of the details. To record these tapes, I used software from the Narrowband Television Association forum called NBSC, or Narrowband Simple Color. I'd like to thank Dominic Beasley for making this software. The first step is to use NBSC Scrape to screen record some video images and save them as a 32 by 48 pixel narrowband TV wave signal. We can have a quick listen to what that sounds like as an audio file. Here we can see the original video as it's being captured. In this case, a Max Headroom impersonator who illegally hijacked TV networks in 1987. For recording onto the Walkman, I transferred the files to this phone, which likely has a cleaner digital to analog converter than, say, my computer. For playback, the Walkman's output is being fed into the mic input on the laptop. with a level attenuator to match the mic input level. Unlike the Max Headroom example, for which I used a Type 1 ferric tape, for this example I used a Type 2 chrome tape, which was able to record some colour, which NBSC adds to the upper part of the 16 kHz bandwidth. The NBSC player software is used for viewing. This software can either load the original WAV file directly or play from any of the sound inputs, such as the mic input, which I'm using here. On the left is the original WAV file, still all digital. For comparison, on the right is the playback after passing through various analog stages. Perhaps you recognize these characters from some old 1987 TV show. This software has many options to experiment with, including filters and built-in scopes. There are also lots of sync options for stabilizing the image. If I turn off the sync options, we can see the raw instability. This is coming from tiny variations in the tape speed. In the audio world, this is called wow and flutter. This much variation is fine for music. You won't really hear it, but for video, it's quite visible. If I play the signal from the phone instead of the tape, you can see the stability difference right there. If I remove the Walkman and feed the phone's headphone output directly into the computer, you can see there is still quite a bit of colour distortion. That very small analog path is still having quite an effect on the fragile signal. I can also play the WAV file directly in the player software. This keeps everything inside the digital domain and keeps the best picture quality in this small bandwidth. The best way to improve video quality would be to increase tape speed. That's when we start getting into VHS, and from there, the sky's the limit. I've really enjoyed this whole process, from messing about with analog TV signals and seeing the results that can be produced, to finally being able to do something I always wanted to do, record video onto audio cassettes. I hope you enjoyed watching this as much as I enjoyed making it.